So what is sequences and how we will talk about the first level of the concept will come here, how to establish that sequence, just most of member of the sequence lies in a very small neighborhood of a point. That point we are calling it a limit or limit point of the sequence. So that we will talk about in detail. Later we will try to get to know how to compute that that specific point. Or limit, that limit of the sequence. That way, so two things would be there. That first we need to mathematically have to, in analytic perspective, we have to come up with epsilon k game, how to claim that a point would be a limit of a sequence. And second would be how to compute that. So there would be two point and two approaches, and both would be computational in sense. So coming to outline of today's lecture, I will talk about first, starting one of this lecture would be neighborhood of a point and limit point of a set. So everyone might have gone through these two concepts. Neighborhood, we had already discussed epsilon, very specific neighborhood that happens to be epsilon neighborhood during order property. We had already discussed. Same thing, we will recall it and try to convert in what in a general framework. So we'll see it. And later, once we are having idea of neighborhood and a limit point, then we'll talk about sequences and the limit of corresponding sequences in detail and how to claim that one point would be a sequence of the limit. That those things we'll discuss in detail, and then we will take we will play epsilon k game. That means you had already seen that that epsilon game with respect to a given epsilon. That epsilon, what does it mean? It happens to be a very small positive real number, or simply you can say that epsilon happens to be 0.00 something, and point it happens to be a number which is arbitrarily close to zero from right. I'm not saying from left. Epsilon is a number which is arbitrarily close to zero. Is suppose here, then epsilon would be somewhere here near to zero. We see that epsilon is very close to zero from right, arbitrarily close to zero. That we are saying that. And with respect to this epsilon, always using Archimedean property. In short, I will write A. P, Archimedean property, is very essential kind of property. With the help of that, through this epsilon, with given epsilon, we will try to come up with one k. So what will happen? We know that epsilon is greater than zero, and hence the multiplicative inverse of epsilon would be also greater than zero. So definitely epsilon is a real number. 1 by epsilon would be also a real number, and hence we can always find a k such that 1 by epsilon would be less than k. Okay, or you can say like this way, 1 by k is less than epsilon. Both are equivalent property. So both are, either you proceed with this or you proceed with this. Okay, so both are coming from Archimedean properties. So we will try to take a lot of benefit of this one, and in order to find establish a number as a limit of a sequence, that we say that here we denote here epsilon. We are coming with our epsilon. It may be 0.01, it may be 0.001, it may be 0.0001, it may be 0.011, various epsilon. Just simply keep in mind that epsilon would be as small as possible. I just somewhere I heard that epsilon, that term actually in mathematics it was introduced by Weierstrass, but idea I think Ramanujam might have given this idea of arbitrary closeness to origin from right, that very small, as small as positive number. That means there is no smallest positive real number. So that okay, so we will play that epsilon k game in order to see limit of a sequence. So coming to first part, yes, k is a natural number. K, a epsilon is a real number. It any a small real, as small as possible real number, and k is a natural number. So in Archimedean property, I had described that k happens to. I have taken notation n, but here I am changing the notation k. So in that we are talking about existence of a natural number. That means that natural number always what happens? It would be a positive integer. It would be a positive integer greater than zero, so that you know that what is natural number. Okay, so nice question. Now we are going further. Ask about everything if there is any issue. Okay, so we are going to talk about neighborhood of a point first, then we will talk about limit point of a set. What is limit point? And in plus two, you might have already gone through. Anyone may comment over this. If you are finding limit of a function, suppose f is a function defined over a certain specified interval, and we are trying to find limit of that function x when x is approaching to a, then suppose f is having a domain A to B. Then tell me, what is meaning of A? Where would be A? What is A? Anyone? Have you think about that? Have you heard any reasoning about that? What would be A? Yeah, A would be just a member from the domain of the function. What would be A? Anyone? You have already gone through this concept in your plus two. So have you heard that? What would be A? What is A? From where A is coming? Yeah, it would be, someone is saying it is a domain. But I can take a point which would be not in the domain of A. Despite of that, we can find limit of a function near to it. It may not be A. Is it true? Have you seen any function where that point where we are trying to find limit of a function may not be in the domain? Have you seen such example? Continuous. Then take this example. Limit 1 by x. X tends to infinity. What is the domain of 1 by x? What is the domain of 1 by x? That simply in term of interval you can talk about minus infinity to, sorry, minus infinity to 0 and union 0 to, sorry, it will bracket 0 to infinity. That 0 is not coming. But we are finding here limit infinity. Whether infinity is coming in the domain of the function? Here infinity, whether it is in the domain of the function, this? Then how you can say that A would be always in the domain of the function? Someone answered that A must be in the domain of the function. What would be that? So definitely you have to think over it now. So it is not necessary that A would be always in the domain of the function. That at which we are trying to find limit, A may or may not be in the domain of the function. Then what would be A? What would be A? If A is not in the domain of A, then why we are finding limit of a function at that point A? And what is the association of A with this state, domain of the function? What is association? So you will see it here. A must be a limit point. It must be a limit point of A. Limit point of A. So that idea we'll discuss it here. What is limit? So and here, if you someone is claiming that what is infinity? Infinity is definitely limit point of this domain of the function. That's why we are calculating the limit of this function 1 by reciprocal function 1 by x when x is approaching to infinity. That's why we are able to calculate. If infinity is not a limit point of this set domain, then we can't calculate. So we are never calculating limit of a given function which is not a limit point, the domain of the function. It must be limit point of the domain of the function. Then we are talking about limit of a function. Otherwise, we can't talk about limit of the function, limit of the function at that point. So that is the essential criteria you need to understand. Okay. So coming to neighborhood of a point, that I told that I will borrow it from order property that we had already discussed about epsilon neighborhood. That happens to be very elementary kind of neighborhood of a point. So consider we are having a real number A, and suppose there is an epsilon, a small positive real number. Then an epsilon neighborhood of A, how we can define it? We can define it as this interval, symmetric interval. It is symmetric with respect to A. This symmetric open interval. You can directly say that symmetric open. So it is a, if you are taking a one-dimensional point, then for one-dimensional point, the epsilon neighborhood happens to be a symmetric one dimensional interval, or simply one dimensional interval. What is meaning of that? That means simply it is an interval. So geometrically, if you are willing to visualize, so this point is, it is here, and you can easily see that the interval which is symmetric about this is what, this open interval a minus epsilon to a plus epsilon, this interval. Okay, so this is the epsilon neighborhood of a point. So remember that epsilon neighborhood of a point in one, for one dimensional point, it would be always symmetric about the point. It is and it would be always interval. So two condition are coming here. This epsilon neighborhood of a point, it would be, first you can say that it is symmetric about a, and hence you can claim that a is the center of the neighborhood due to symmetry. You can see that circle, if you take circle, every point on the circumference happens to be symmetric about the center. That's why that one is the name of center. So it is symmetric. This one is symmetric about A. First, second point you have to highlight that it depends upon nature of what point you are taking. You are taking a real point or you are taking a real number. So when we are saying point, that means a real number, you have just pointed a drawn in a real line. So that's why we are talking about point. So if you are taking a real number A from, okay, so definitely it is one dimensional point. There is only one dimension. So with respect to that, what is this epsilon neighborhood? It would be just an open interval with center A. So this point is always center. So you can write, so I have already written here, so you can copy it. Epsilon neighborhood would be this. Okay, I think in concept of epsilon neighborhood might be clear to everyone. So we'll go forward. We'll try to find epsilon neighborhood of our interest. Generally, we try to find limit of a function or limit of a sequence around infinity or origin. So that depends upon what kind of things that comes. That's why we will try to first define epsilon neighborhood of origin. Okay, what does it talk about? So epsilon neighborhood of origin, again, it would be take origin in the real line and draw a symmetric interval with, also epsilon you can talk it radius of the interval. Definitely it is one dimensional real number. If you are taking one dimensional real number, then what is movement? Movement is just to and forward and backward. That means there is only one dimensional movement. Okay, one dimensional movement. So that's where you talk about here radius, you talk about center, everything is visible here. Why you always talk about one dimensional movement? So origin is the one dimensional movement. And what is the epsilon neighborhood of origin? So simply you have to walk forward with up to epsilon distance. You have to walk backward up to my negative epsilon distance. So that's where here we are getting epsilon neighborhood of this origin. It happens to be an open interval minus epsilon to plus epsilon. It is an open interval. You can easily see that. Okay. Now we will talk about next. What is epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity? Anyone, have you heard that epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity? And if you talk about a real number, there are two big symbols, minus infinity and plus infinity. Okay, so those are symbols. Just so we are trying to find what is the what is meaning of epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity. So simply it says that in epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity, it is a collection of all those real numbers which are greater than 1 by epsilon. Definitely epsilon would be very small positive real number, and if you take as much as a small, you can take okay, it depends upon your choice. So if you're taking as much as a small, then relatively you can say that if you take reciprocal of that, then one by epsilon, it would be as large as possible, as large as possible. So if positive epsilon is having not non-symmetric epsilon neighborhood, so your epsilon is non-symmetric, that means one half, you can say that simply. So you are taking positive epsilon, so just it is having left neighborhood. So everything, if you take real number, then infinity would be something like this way. We can't represent that, that one is not a real number, so that's way. So what is happening that we try to find only left part of the neighborhood of epsilon infinity. That happens to be any number which is for epsilon, take any epsilon, and any number which falls after 1 by epsilon, we are saying after 1 by epsilon, those will be included as member of neighborhood of epsilon neighborhood of plus infinity. So that's the same thing we have written like this way. Oh, now further, if you simplify it, then you will see that if you are willing to find epsilon neighborhood of infinity, it is just equivalent to find zero neighborhood with transform point 1 by epsilon, 1 by x. Same thing, it is just zero is just our, we can talk about zero. So that's why you can say. So here again, it is right, becomes a right. So if x is, we are saying x is falling in the epsilon neighborhood of infinity, then correspondingly, if you take reciprocal of x, that will fall in the right neighborhood of neighborhood with 1 by reciprocal. That means 1 by, if x is the point in the epsilon neighborhood of infinity, then here you can say that it is the right neighborhood, okay, in the left neighborhood of infinity. Only in fact, infinity is having left part of neighborhood. So the correspondingly 1 by x will have only right part of neighborhood. So that is the concept of neighborhood of epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity. Similarly, you can talk about you can talk about epsilon neighborhood of negative infinity. So what would be that? It would be anything before negative 1 by epsilon, negative 1 by epsilon. So that would be what? Epsilon neighborhood of negative infinity. Likewise, also you can talk about for this perspective, you can talk about here, it would be what? A negative, here you can put epsilon, so it will fall, 1 by x will fall here for negative. Here, remember that 1 by x is negative number here for negative, negative. So this one is equivalent to this part and this one is equivalent to this part, you can say like this way. So this is the positive epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity and epsilon neighborhood of negative infinity. Same thing we will see here in case of sequence. Sequence, we will talk about, always we say that in sequence limit, when we are finding limit n tends to infinity, then we will look for what? Neighborhood of, epsilon neighborhood of positive infinity. So that's why I'm discussing this. Okay, next part of this lecture is that limit part, limit point. So it is very much essential to understand what is limit point of a set. Limit point of a set. So if you try to see what layman or informal definition of limit point, then we can say that limit point of a set, it is a point, very specific point, which has points of S other than the point itself arbitrarily close to it. That means if you are taking a point, there is a meaning of arbitrary close, and you are having a set S, then you will say that A is a what? A is a limit point of S. A would be, suppose it is here, then always you can find some point of S which would be very near to this A, some point, at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or infinitely many. So at least one point of S would fall that would be very near to A. That is the concept of limit point. So we will say that A is the limit point. So if you try to talk about very celebrated kind of things, so if you take any celebrated person, suppose Amitabh Bachchan is visiting here Hubli, then can we find what kind of, can we find any specific region where the Amitabh Bachchan will be alone? Yeah, Dharwad or Hubli, what? Both are twin city. No, Dharwad will be, it would be not limit point. Amitabh Bachchan would be the limit point. Okay, so what is happening that if you take any small neighborhood of Amitabh Bachchan or any another celebrity, then if you try to make a circle around him, then definitely in that circle, at least one person would be there. At least one person were there. So wherever one celebrity goes, that celebrity becomes a limit point, because there is no any circle in which you will find only that person itself. Definitely there would be some other person, either bodyguards and either a fan or something like that. Definitely someone would be there. So that is the concept that what is limit point? Limit point is a celebrated point, you can simply that. It is a one kind of celebrated point that may be in the set or may not be in that set. But if you take any, if you try to zoom the point, then definitely you will see that near about that point, arbitrary near, near, don't say just near. You can say that arbitrary near. What does it mean? That means as much close as possible to that point. If you try to just keep on go as much as possible near to that point, definitely you will get one point of the given set. So that's where A becomes a limit point of the set. That is the meaning of informal meaning of limit point. Now we try in mathematics everything we want to express in term of what we call it formal language, so we will express that. So just here in the in the same informal framework, we had already seen the what we call it supremum and infimum kind of concept. So from there we can talk about if you take zero, it would be a limit point of interval 0 to 1, interval 0 to 1. Why? We know that if you take zero here, zero would be somewhere here. So if you take zero and then in this in the very small neighborhood of zero, near about zero, we will get a point 1 by n. If we keep on increasing n, 1 by n is going to approach to zero. So we will get various 1 by n near about zero. As much as n you increase, it will just move towards origin. But 1 by n is where n is a natural number, so 1 by n would be always positive. Always positive, greater than zero. But here, 1 by n, it will approach to zero from right. It will approach to zero from right. So that's way. If you see zero and zoom it out, then right hand side you can find always at least one member of the set 0, 1, interval 0, 1. Always you can find. We know that 1 by n belongs to, it belongs to interval 0 to 1. For n being a natural number, it always belongs to 0, 1. So that's way always we, so that's why zero is a limit point of this interval. Even zero is a limit point of open interval 0 to 1. Because 1 by n is greater than zero, 1 by n would be a member of this open interval as well. So that's why we can say that zero is also a limit point of open interval 0, 1. But zero is not in this interval; it is out of the interval. So zero is what? Actually, zero is actually infimum of this set. And we had already done enough example on infimum of a set. So let us recall. So I did discuss about all the informal approach. Let us just focus on formal approach. So what is formal approach? So we consider L is any real number. Then this real number we will call it a celebrated point or limit point of the given set S. If for every epsilon, take any epsilon, every means any, take any epsilon arbitrary, okay, take any epsilon, epsilon greater than zero, that means epsilon, always, one hint is that always take value of epsilon as small as possible, but must be positive, okay. So, L, it would be a limit point of the given set S if for every epsilon, there exists a epsilon neighborhood of the number L, which contain at least one point of S other than the number L itself. So here we never talk about L, whether it would be in the set S or not. So just we are talking about S, L would be a real number. So that's with focus on this. We never talk about whether L would be in the set S itself or not. We always say that just find out an epsilon neighborhood of L and try to see, zoom it out, try to see whether that any, suppose someone is saying that just play epsilon game here. Someone is saying that I am taking 0.001. Then is it possible to find, call it epsilon 1? Is it possible to find a member of S in this epsilon 1 neighborhood of L? If you are getting a member of S in this neighborhood, it is very fine. Then someone will say that, okay, you have taken a little bit bigger epsilon. Why not you take a smaller epsilon? Take then another one came and take a much smaller epsilon, 0.001. And with respect to that, you will get epsilon 2 neighborhood of L. Again, if this interval is also containing some member of the set S, then you can further take as small as possible. Keep on doing that. And in that process, what is happening that every epsilon neighborhood of L is containing some point of S, then simply we will say that actually that point L is what? It is a limit point of the given set. That is the meaning of limit point of a set. Okay. So here, same example, I am taking it to what I had discussed in informal way, that if you are taking interval 0, 1 as set example, then if you take any epsilon in the form of 1 by k, any epsilon 1 by k, then we know that from Archimedean principle, what does it, what we know from Archimedean principle? So if you're taking epsilon, a real number, then 1 by epsilon and positive real and positive, a small positive real number, and then as small as possible, then 1 by epsilon would be also a real number, but it would be very large. With respect to that, there exists a natural number k. I am writing it here, natural number. So that means k belongs to n, such that we'll say it 1 by epsilon would be dominated by k, or we can say that 1 by k is less than epsilon. 1 by k is less than epsilon. So that's way, if you take any, what is happening? So with respect to this epsilon, every 1 by n would be what? It would be less than 1 by k, and hence less than epsilon. That means simply we say that all these 1 by n, where n is greater than or equal to k, happens to be in the epsilon neighborhood of 0. It contains epsilon number. So we know that if n, we are taking a natural number which is greater than k, that happens to, we got it with respect to this epsilon. And if you take reciprocal, then what will happen? 1 by n would be less than equal to 1 by k. And we had already seen that 1 by k is less than epsilon from Archimedean principle. So what does it talk about? So if you take, what does it talk about geometrically if you visualize? So 0 you have taken in a point, and we are trying to claim that 0 is the limit point of this interval or this set. So if you take an epsilon, then, and this epsilon is what? This epsilon is 1 by k, 1 by capital K, then every 1 by n where n is greater than or equal to k would fall here between 0 and epsilon. That means it is in the, and what is 1 by epsilon? It is a member of the given set. It is the member of given set, and hence we can say that zero, every neighborhood of 0 is containing some point of the given set S that happens to be an unit interval, and hence 0 is a limit point of this set. That is the definition of limit point. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Any response? Okay, fine. Now let us call other example. Talk about one set S1, that one is unit interval 0 to 1. Another set, take 0 to. So if you say these two set, then 1 is the limit point of these two set S1 and S2 as well. So why? Because if you take any member, if you take any member, if you take a sequence like this, 0.9.099.999.999, keep on increasing the 9. Okay, so what will happen? So definitely where this will fall. So if you take a real line here, 1 is here, so all these points would be here, all these points would be here. So, and again, what you observe, these points are coming from S1, these points are coming from S1. So if you take any small, so what we call small neighborhood of 1, call it take 0.1, even you can take 0.1, or you can take here epsilon equal to 0.1. What will happen? This interval, 1 minus 0.1, epsilon we have taken 0.1. So what is 1 minus epsilon? 1 minus 0.1 would be 0.9, or you can a little bit take it much smaller, 1.09. You can take it 1.09. Oh, epsilon take even less. Simply, I would like to say that take epsilon less than 0.1. From that segment, you can say that this 1 minus epsilon and epsilon containing all these points. Containing all these points, you can easily say that. So that's way, 1 is the limit point of this set S1. Now, someone may suggest how one would be a limit point of this second set S2. Any idea? Anyone just try to come up with a suitable epsilon? What epsilon would be here? 1.99, that one is a point of the set, but epsilon, I'm talking about epsilon, it would be a small positive real number. as small as possible. It depends upon your choice. So what you do, take a epsilon which is just less than 0.1. Yeah, so less than 0.1, then you will get a right neighborhood of 1, this one, and these here you can, this interval contains point like 1.1, 1.1, 1. It will keep on going like this way. 1.01, various point would be there. Like in that process, you can like what you have come up with 1.11, 1. Sorry, 09, 1.09, 1.99, and even 1.9099. So those point will come 1.099. And likewise, you can keep on doing 1.0999. Various point would be here in this interval, and those are what? Those are coming from S2. So if you take as small as possible epsilon value of epsilon, definitely you will get a neighborhood of 1, which contains infinitely many point of 0.2 interval or set S2. Even if you define, so that's way one is again a limit point of this set S2. So that is the criteria of defining limit points. So I'm asking few question. Tell me, what is the limit point of interval? What are the limit point of this interval? Find all possible limit point. Anyone? What are the collection of limit points? So find whether 0 is a limit point of this given set or S or not. No. Take interval 0 is here. Then take epsilon 0.1, something like that. Epsilon, take epsilon. So this interval, 0 to epsilon, definitely contains in set S. That means 0 to epsilon, it is containing many member of S. Then how you can say that 0 is not a limit point of S? I have taken interval 0 to 1, 1 to 2, union like this. So definitely this here, various, if you take a small neighborhood of this right neighborhood of 0, then you observe that there are various member of S. So we can say that 0 is a limit point. 0 is a limit point. What about 1? 1 is a limit point or not? Of this set, anyone? No. One is also limit point. If you take 1, and even if you take right hand side, it is not like that. Whether you take complete symmetric epsilon neighborhood, you can take one part of that. That would be enough. So just you have to zoom out. There is any arbitrary closed member of that set or not? So if you take a epsilon, then with respect to the defined neighborhood, 1 minus epsilon and 1. So definitely 1 minus and epsilon and 1. It is just a subset of open interval 0 to 1. Is it true or not? Epsilon is take like 0.1 or 0.001. Like this one, you can take anything, depends upon you. If you want to visualize geometrically, just take a numeric value of epsilon and try to see it. Only facility that take a value of epsilon as much as small as possible, but must be positive. So definitely 1 minus epsilon 1, it would be a subset of 0, 1. That means if you take any member of the set, definitely it will be in this here. It will be near to 1. So 1 is also a limit point of this set. Likewise, if I talk about 2, 2 is a limit point of this set or not? Do a lot of practice, then it will be clear. Yeah, very nice. So here, definitely we will get a neighborhood. Here, right hand side will not contain, but left hand part, that means 2 minus epsilon, 2 minus, here take interval, 2 minus epsilon, 2. It is definitely, it is a subset of 1, 2. It is a subset of 1, 2. That means here we are getting infinitely many member of this set, this part of set. So that's where 2 is also a limit point. So 0 is a limit point, 2 is a limit point, and any member between 0 and 1 is a limit point. So that's where the collection of all limit point of this set would be closed interval 0 to 1. So the collection of all limit point of a set we denote it by S dash. We are putting dash, or name of that we are calling it derived set. So what is the derived set of this one? It is the closed interval 0 to 2. It is a, we say that it is a derived set of S. We write it like this. That means collection of all the limit point of a given set. So remember that we always find limit of a function in at some limit point. Limit of function, some limit point. So that's where where we are finding limit, that must be a member of derived set. So it is here. Likewise, if you take a unit interval, open interval 0 to 1, so call it S1. Then what would be derived set? That means collection of all limit point. Just instantly give answer. What would be derived set of this open interval 0 to 1? Anyone? What is 0 to 1? 0 to 1 actually, whether it is open or closed? It is closed. Why open? Because 0 is also a limit point of this set. If you take any small neighborhood of 0, definitely that contains infinitely many points of the set S. Again, same thing I am trying to visualize it here. So take 0 is it here, and take a very small neighborhood of 0, very small epsilon, positive epsilon, then definitely this part, this interval containing infinitely many points of open interval 0, 1. Infinitely many points. So that's where 0 is a limit point. And if you take any point from the set itself, when it is continuous in nature, then by default that would be a limit point. There we will get a symmetric kind of epsilon neighborhood. Symmetric, if you are taking interior point, then inside point, then you will get interior symmetric neighborhood. But 0 and 1 happens to be terminal point. So with respect to that, just 1/2 of epsilon neighborhood will come. Definitely 1/2 is enough to contain infinitely many points of the set itself. If it is containing infinitely many points, just we have to look for which part of the epsilon neighborhood is containing some element of that or not, that given set or not. If it is containing, we will claim that that would be a limit point. Likewise, if you take 1, then definitely if you take left hand side limit, so left hand side epsilon neighborhood, that means 1 minus epsilon and 1. So 1 minus epsilon and 1, it is containing infinitely many point of interval 0, 1. So that's why 1 is also a limit point of this set open interval 0, 1, and hence the derived set would be 0 to 1. That means every member of closed interval 0 to 1 would be a limit point of the given set S1. That means, what does it say? That means if you're taking any member from closed interval 0 to 1, then with respect to that member, you will get various element of S1 which would be arbitrarily close to that member. So that is the thing. Now, next question I'm asking, if suppose take S2 equal to this closed interval 0, 1, tell me what would be collection of limit point, what would be derived set S2? Anyone? What would be derived set? Just try to answer it. Yeah, very nice. It is a closed interval 0 to 1. By default, 0 is already inside the set itself. So very nice. There is no issue. So even open interval, the derived set is closed interval 0 to 1. If it is a closed interval, derived set is again a closed interval 0 to 1. So nice. So this way you have to find all the collection of all the limit points. Why you are finding? Because you are trying to find next job would be what? You have to find the limit of the function at that point. So that's why you are trying to do that. It is already above 45 minutes. So next thing we will cover in next class. And regarding attendance, just put your roll number there in the comment box. And